Mr. Singh was just said he's going to support the budget, so I guess the political drama is out of it. But he still says, I don't believe you. Liberals have made promises, frankly, Chrystia Freeland, since you and I were kids, to talk about childcare. They've never done it. What do you say to Mr. Singh, who says, this is a campaign promise, I got to see it to believe it?
Well, first of all, I didn't hear your whole interview, Evan. But you say that Mr. Singh said he will support the budget, and I'd like to say thank you very much. And I think that's the right choice. This is a progressive budget that's going to deliver jobs and growth for Canadians. So that's great news. When it comes to early learning and childcare and whether people should believe we're going to get it done, Evan, you are completely right. People have been trying to do this for more than 50 years. And I'm intimately acquainted with that because my mother was a sort of a rabble-rousing feminist in Peace River in the early 70s. And when I was 2 years old, that's when the Royal Commission on the Status of Women advised the federal government to build an early learning and childcare system across the country. And I still remember these Peace River ladies coming to our kitchen, and they were all talking about Royal Commission on the Status of Women. I didn't really know what that was. So women have been fighting for this for a long, long time. There are three differences today, Evan. First difference, we have put our money where our mouth is. $30 billion over 5 years, more than $9 billion ongoing. That is a very significant commitment. We can do a lot with that money. Second difference, I really think, is Quebec. People now see across the country that this is not some progressive feminist pipe dream. This is something real. It can happen, and it can deliver real economic results. You know, our guys here in the Ministry of Finance, they think this could be the economic policy for Canada that moves the dial on economic growth the most since NAFTA, and could deliver 1.2% of GDP. That's a lot. And the third difference, I think, Evan, is COVID. I think COVID has been an epiphany for a lot of people, and they have seen that without childcare, parents, and actually usually mothers, just can't work. And the numbers show it. We have the biggest drop in women's participation in the labor force in two decades. So I do not underestimate how hard this is. There's going to be a lot of work ahead, but I am totally committed to it. Our government is. I think Canadians believe in this and want it. We're going to get it done.
Okay. I mean, because there's likely an election before you can negotiate with the provinces because it's a provincial jurisdiction. Just very quickly, because I know your time is limited. What about the people in Quebec? I know the Bloc wants no strings attached. They've already got this. They've had this for 20 years. It cost them, by the way, over $2 billion. So I know this is $6 billion a year for the rest of the country, but it's an expensive program, as you know. Will Quebec get money? What happens to Quebec? Do they just get their share of the $6 billion to offset their existing cost to childcare? Like, how do you negotiate that with each province?
Well, you are totally right, Evan. What we're going to need to do is have bilateral negotiations with each province and territory, and we're really looking forward to that. I think Quebec is going to be a big, big winner here, and I actually think our bilateral negotiations with Quebec are going to be among the easiest because Quebec already has a system, and the good news for them is after doing it for 20 years on their own, they're going to have the federal government helping them out.
Okay, I know you got to go. People are going to know, wow, these are massive deficits, $354 billion. Not a lot of revenue there, Minister. How will you actually pay for all this?
Well, first of all, Evan, let me just point out that the $354 billion for last year is actually significantly below our projection of $381.6 billion. So that's some good news, and it shows that we're careful in our forecasting. I would also really point out to people, this is reasonable and sustainable. We have a declining debt to GDP ratio. We get down to a deficit of 1.1% in 25-26. And how we're going to pay for it is through jobs and growth. And that's what this budget is going to deliver.
I know you got to run. You got an incredibly busy schedule. That is the Finance Minister, Chrystia Freeland, joining us on the special tonight. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Also, good to deliver the news that looks like the government's not going to fall on your budget. Thank you, Minister. Appreciate it.
Thank you very much for that news, Evan. Great to talk to you.